Second talk is applying MILP method to searching integral distinguishers based on division property for six lightweight block ciphers by Zhen Jun Chan, Wen Tao Zhang, Zhen Zhen Bao, Dan Dai Lin. Talk is given by Zhen Jun Chan.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Zhe Junxiang. The title of this talk is Applying a MILP Method to Searching Integral Distinguishers Based on Division Property for Six Lightweight Block Ciphers. This is the overview of the talk. Firstly, we will review division property, and then we show how to combine a MILP method with division property. And last, we present a search algorithm and show some applications. First of all, we should take a look at some new notions. For any fixed U, pi ux is a Boolean function. It's divided as the product of some chosen bit of x, and we use vector u to choose the corresponding bit. So if n equals to 4, m equals to 2, pi ux can be computed as 0 to the power of 0 times 1 to the power of 1, and so on. So the value of pi ux equals to 0 in this particular situation. Next, if k and k star are two vectors, if ki is greater than or equal to ki star, so in this case, we will say k is greater than or equal to k star. Otherwise, we say k is not greater than or equal to k star. Now we review the definition of division property. Division property is introduced by Todo at Eurocrypto 2015. It's a generalized integral property. Let x be a subset of f2n to the power of m, and ki be m dimensional vectors. X has the division property dk0, k1 to kq minus 1 if the sum of pi ux equals to 0 for all u belongs to this set. In this expression, wu represents the vectorial Hamming weight of u, and wtu0 represents the Hamming weight of u0. So now, with the help of division property, we can search integral distinguishers for block ciphers. Firstly, we need to construct an input set with division property dk0, and then we propagate the initial division property r round to get dkr. At last, we try to extract some useful integral property from DKR. So in order to use division property, we need to know the propagation rules. Next, we show some propagation rules for division property. For copy operation, the division property propagation is just to decompose the key value into all possible combinations. For XOR cooperation, for XOR operation, the division property propagation is just to add the two coordinates of the input division property. For AND operation, the division property is to try to find the maximum value of the input division property. Now the division property is defined and computed on f2n to the power of fm. If n equals to 1, this is the bit-based division property. So bit-based division property treats each bit independently, so it can describe much more detailed division property, and it can find longer distinguishers and better result. But however, bit-based division property need much more computations. At FSE 2016, bit-based division property can only apply to Simon 32 and CMAC 32. So in the following of this talk, we focus on how to compute bit-based division property efficiently. The overall strategy here is to use mixed integer linear programming method to characterize the division property propagations. MILP problem tries to find the minimal or maximum value of an object function on some linear constraints. In this model, M is a constant matrix, A is a constant vector. A part of all the variables in X are restricted in integers. So in order to complete this conversion, we need to address two issues. The first one is to describe the division property propagations by linear inequalities. The second one is to convert a search program to estimate the minimum value of the object function. To facilitate this conversion, we present a new launching here. Assume the input set to the block cipher has initial division property dk, and denote the division property after I round encryption by dki. So we have this chain of division property propagations. For any k0, k1 to kr belongs to the product space of big k0 to big kr. If ki minus 1 can propagate to ki for all I, then we call k0 to kr an unround division trio. So based on the definition of division trio, we can see that the set of the last vectors of all our round division trios, which start with k, is equal to kr. So now, give an input division property, we do not need to compute k0, k1, k2 step by step. We only need to find all the division trios and check the last vectors of the division trio. But still, we don't know what kind of property we should check for the last vectors. So this proposition gives a sufficient and a necessary condition of a set to have no integral property. Assume X is a set with division property dk, then X does not have integral property if and only if K contains all the n unit vectors. So in this case, give initial division property dk and the round number R, there doesn't exist R round distinguisher if and only if there exist n division trios which start with the initial division property k and ends up with the n unit vectors. So now the problem is quite clear. We just need to find n division trios. Next, we can proceed to the first issue. Describe the division propagations by linear inequalities. We will address these issues by modeling some basic operations used in the block cipher by linear inequalities. The first one is the copy operation. This is the general propagation rules for division property. And for bit-based situation, n equals to 1. Based on this propagation rule, we can find three division trails for copy operation. And then, if A to B0, B1 is a division trail of copy operation, this equality is sufficient to describe these propagations, because all the feasible solutions of this equality are all the three division trails of copy operation. So similarly, for XOR operation, this is the general propagation rule. And for bit-based situation, n equals to 1. For this case, we can compute three division trails for XOR operation. For this particular situation, K0 and K1 equals to 1, this propagation will abort, because in this case, K0 plus K1 equals to 2, which is greater than 1. Since we consider bit-based division property here, so this division trio is invalid. Next, if we denote A0, A1 to be a division trio of XOR operation, this equality is sufficient to describe these propagations. Now for AND operation, this is the general rule, and this is the bit-based situation. So we can compute four division trails for AND operation, and we can compute three inequalities to describe the propagation. We can check that all the feasible solutions of these three inequalities are the four division trails of AND operation. Next, we show how to model S-box. We take present S-box scale as an example. Assume this is the input division property of S-box, and we calculate the algebraic normal of present S-box. So from this input division property, we know that only the sum of these two monomials are unknown. But we can observe y0, y2, these two Boolean functions does not contain these two monomials. So the sum of y0 and y2 are 0. Moreover, we can compute Y0 times Y2. And we found Y0 times Y2 does not contain these two monomials. So the sum of Y0 times Y2 is also zero. Based on these observations, the output division property should be D0010 and 1000. So follow this similar idea, we present a generalized an algorithm to compute the division truth of any S-box. The input to the algorithm is the input division property of n-bit S-box and k equals to kn-1 to k0. And the output is a subset of all n-dimensional binary vectors, such that the output division property is dk. So firstly, we initialize S bar as all the vectors greater than or equal to k. And according to the definition of division property, fx denotes all the unknown monomials. So for all u belongs to f2 to the power of n, we compute pi uy and check if this Boolean function contains any monomial of fx. If so, the sum of pi uy is unknown. And in this situation, we add u to k bar. At last, we run a size reduced procedure on k bar to return k as the output. So based on this algorithm, we can compute the division trails for present S-box. These are the 47 division trails we found for present S-box. This entry marked with red are the two division trails we computed in the example. So now for any n-bit S-box, we can compute all division trails by the algorithm. And then we treat the division trail as two n-dimensional vectors. At last, according to Sun's idea, we can compute a set of linear inequalities with the help of Sage software. And all the feasible solutions are all the division trail. So these are the 11 inequalities we found for present S-box. In this inequality, A3, A2, A1, A0 denote the input division property, and the B3, B2, B1, B0 is the output division property. So now for any block cipher based on copy, XOR, and S-box operations, we can construct a linear inequality system to describe the division property propagations, but still we don't know the division property of each round. We don't know K0 or K1 because this linear inequality doesn't contain any information of the input division property. So if this is an R-round division trail and let K equals to Kn-1 to K0, we should add A0i equals to Ki for all I into the model. Now the input division property has been added into the model. So we know K0, and then according to the propagation rules, we know Ki, K1, K2, Kr. Thus, we have solved the first issues. Now we can proceed to the second issue, convert the search program to estimate the minimum value of the object function. And we know that if Kr contains all the n unit vectors, R round integral distinguisher doesn't exist. So if this is an R-round division trail, we can set the sum of the coordinates of the last vectors as the object function. And we try to find the minimum value of this object function. If the minimum value of this object function equals to 1, then we have found a unit vector. So now for any block cipher, given an input division property, we can construct a set of linear inequalities to describe the division property propagations for the input division property. And then we set the sum of the coordinates of the last vectors as the object function. Combine this set of linear inequality and the object function, we can get a MILP model. And this model will be the input of the search algorithm. And the output of the search algorithm is set S. And this set will indicate balanced bit positions. Firstly, we initialize S as all the possible bit positions. And then we try to repeat this procedure n times. N is the block size of the block cipher. And for each time, we check if M has feasible solutions. If so, we optimize this model and try to get the objective value. If the objective value equals to 1, we have found a unit vector, and we let P denote the bit position take a value 1 in the object function. In this case, P is an unbalanced bit position, so we need to exclude P from S and remove the unit vector from M, and we try to optimize this model again. So if this procedure stops, we will get a set S as the output. If this set is empty, then R round integral distinguisher doesn't exist. If this set is non-empty, then we have found some balanced bit positions for R round encryption. This table shows some applications of this search algorithm. We can find better result for Simon and CMacBook ciphers, except for Simon 32 and CMac 32. We can also find a better result for present and rectangle block ciphers. For the last two block ciphers, we find the same result. We can find the same result as the previous best result. The more important data is this column. This column shows the execution time of this search algorithm. And among these ciphers, Simon 128 took the most time, but it's still less than an hour on a personal desktop. So this algorithm is quite efficient and practical. Okay, those are some references. Thank you.
Any question and comment? We have a lot of time to discuss.
Can you please go to the slide where you show the objective function?
Here?
So you're trying to minimize, again, what are you trying to minimize?
We try to find the minimum value of this expression, the sum of the coordinates of the last vector of the division trio.
Question or comment? Okay, let's thank speaker again.